Your life is not a reality show. Your life is for you to live and you alone, not any other person. Success also is not the number of followers you have on social media. Now, I think I need to allow this for those at the back. Success is not the number of your followers on Instagram, okay? Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Tara. If this is your first time here, I thank you so much for tuning in. And if you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for coming back. Please don't forget to hit on the red subscribe button if you're not yet subscribed, and put on your post notification so you're notified every single time. You're the first to know. That's how it works. Immediately I drop a video, YouTube notifies you, and then you can watch, you know, whenever you like, but at least you know every single time that I post a new video, okay? So in today's video, guys, I'm going to be doing some sort of like sequel, in some way, some sort of sequel to the last video about, you know, pressure and overcoming destination anxiety that I made. Check out that video here if you're yet to see it. I just talked about, you know, the pressure to achieve certain things at certain ages and how it is not realistic. There's no such thing as a perfect plan. You don't need certain things to live a fulfilled life or have happily ever after, especially if those things are based on what society, you know, calls achievements or fulfillment, okay? So yeah, again, in today's video, as the title already suggests, I'm going to be talking about the measurements of success, what society has defined as success, what society has portrayed as success to us, and what we also have, you know, digested as what success should look like, feel like, and be measured as. Okay, success is such a popular notion that a lot of people have spoken about, especially when it comes to the motivational speakers of the world. Authors have written a whole lot of books about success. In fact, I feel if there was no such thing as success, the number of books that, you know, tend towards the motivational aspect might probably not be as much as they are right now. But I mean, success opened up the way for a lot of these authors and motivational speakers to come into limelight, which is okay. It's okay. However, I feel, you know, these talks, these books, and what society just portrays basically tends to now cause what I see as an unrealistic standard for measuring success. And as such, I'm just going to be, you know, explaining my experiences with different people, a couple of people, about what success is to them, as well as how you yourself can find your own ruler or measurement for success. So if you know you can relate to all of these things that I've said, and you know you would like to see how success can measure success based on your own standard, then please do keep on watching this video. So guys, before I proceed into this video, I'm just quickly going to ask for you guys to help me out with something in the comment section. So what is success to you? What does success mean to you? Please drop a comment in the comment section below. I would like to read through this. Having said that, guys, I'm just going to go ahead to divide this video into three parts. The first part is, what is success, or what should success feel like? The second part is, what success isn't, or what success shouldn't feel like? And then the third part is, how to find your own success measurement or ruler. So guys, the very first part, which happens to be, what is success, or what success should feel like? To me, success should depend on you. So success is dependent on you. What you define as success is what success is. I hope you got that. You tell people, or you tell yourself, what success is. Yes, you get to do that. Nobody should get to tell you what success is or what it should feel like. You should tell yourself what success is. Now, I'm just going to quickly chip in here that about a couple of years ago, or maybe going down to 3 years ago, I was in a particular gathering, and this conversation stemmed where there was this particular man. Yes, it was even a man that, you know, just came to say, you know what, he feels like he just wants to, you know, live a comfortable life in terms of, you know, having a good job, or just having a good job or something that just brings in a good income, and him being able to take care of himself and then his family. And, you know, he just wants a nice little house, a nice car, nothing too big, nothing too fancy. Both guys and ladies were checking him out and like, be a guy because, you know, in this part of the world especially, guys are seen as like the breadwinner. So it's difficult to be able to process when a guy as such tells you that, oh, my own definition for success or how I want to live my own life, you just have nice little cute and cozy things of the world, you know. And then one of the people that were in that gathering just posted up to him and was like, why should you settle for less when you can have something greater? And yes, I know that this is a saying that is true in a lot of things, but not how you want to live your life overall. Good is okay. Good sometimes can be better than great. Okay, you can decide that you just want to live like a fulfilled life. Yes, that is also, I'm coming to that to say that success should also feel like fulfillment, having a sense of purpose. Just, you know, you want to have like a nice house, maybe a 3-bedroom apartment, not necessarily a mansion, or even in Lekki, not even talk of Ikoyi, Banana Island and the likes. But yes, you can decide to have, you know, something just cute and cozy and little. You can decide to have a little, you know, nice Corolla car that is working perfectly as opposed to having a Lamborghini or a Range Rover. Who says that success has to be you driving it? In fact, success, I don't think is any of those things anyway. But I'm just saying that what you define success as is what success is to you. So you get to define what success is. You get to say how success should feel like to you. Okay, so yeah, that conversation hasn't left my head, and then I just realized that some people actually are not as ambitious, and it's okay, it's fine. A lot of people are ambitious. I count myself as one of the ambitious people, but like I said in my former video, my last video, about, you know, the old pressure thing, that you should know when to, you know, take a break. You know, you should know when to step on the brakes of ambition. Step on it sometimes so you can be in the moment and enjoy the moment, because at the end of the day, you work and work and work for all of these things. Who's to say that you're going to be here to enjoy it anyway? Say what you want success to be to you. Define success is basically all that I'm saying. Okay guys, moving on to the second part, which is what success isn't, or what success shouldn't feel like. So this is probably going to be even shorter than the first part, because this is going to be straight to the point. So guys, success shouldn't be what society has defined it as, or shouldn't be the standard of what society uses to measure success. Success also shouldn't be based on wealth or living an expensive life. Let me put it that way, you know, having an expensive lifestyle. Also, success shouldn't be you living a life that is basically directed at making other people feel envious. So if you're living a life just because you want to make A or B or neighbor D feel envious of you, then trust me, you're not living a life of, you're living your life for them. You're living your life for their spectacle. You want them to keep looking at you and say, oh, this person did this, that person did this. How are you going to even enjoy a sense of fulfillment anyway, which is a large part of what makes up success at the end of the day, if we're looking at it from a general aspect. So yeah, you living a life that is, you know, directed or that is targeted at making other people feel envious of you isn't what success should feel like at all. Success also is not the number of followers you have on social media. Now, I think I need to loud this for those at the back. Success is not the number of your followers on Instagram. Okay? You can live a fulfilled life without even being on the internet. I mean, the internet provides a lot of avenue for you to, you know, be able to relax, have fun, even connect, meet people, find jobs. Yes, but I'm still sure that there are people that don't have, like, maybe just one, maybe just Facebook or just Instagram, that don't have everything, as opposed to you with sitting down to be accumulating followers just so that, you know, you can have like maybe 10,000 followers and then you're following maybe 200. And in their mind, that's success. That is not success, my dears. There are a lot of people that have thousands, even millions of followers that don't feel successful. They don't feel fulfilled yet. Please add in the comment section if you have, you know, more ideas about what success isn't. I think I already asked earlier on what success means to you. Now, tell me on a general note, what do you think success should not be? Or what do you think success should not feel like? Those things that I've mentioned, I don't think success should feel like them. You forcing yourself to even live a lifestyle that you can't afford. I mean, you might normally be comfortable, but then going a step ahead to now live a lifestyle specifically for the whole purpose of you appearing as successful isn't what success is, or what success should feel like. Okay? Now moving on to the third aspect of this video, how to find your own success measurement or ruler. Now, like I said earlier in this video, you defining what success is what should be your standard for measuring how successful you are or you can be. But I would like to put out there that sometimes we are truly already successful with the little things we do. So now, for example, if I set a goal or a target for myself, say to film, and in a month I've been doing 2 videos a week on YouTube now, so that's 8 videos now, me being able to achieve that, because trust me, like I said, I have a whole lot of other things going on as well, not just YouTube is not paying me yet, and as such I have to also put a lot of my energy into like regular work that would definitely bring in money for me to be able to sustain myself until when YouTube starts to pay me gradually. Okay, now if I have set a goal for 8 videos a month on YouTube, and because I know that I have these other engagements and commitments, if I happen to film that 8th video and also edit, because editing is also different from filming, success can come from me being able to film, edit and put up 8 videos, because that's my target. So set targets, set it in little bits gradually to add up to something. But if you put your mind first on saying, oh, I want to do this because this other person is doing, you're not going to do it as well, even if at all you end up doing it, or you're going to do it based on, you know, how that person has also done it. What makes your own difference? So yeah, setting goals and targets for yourself, by yourself, should be one of the measurements and rulers for success. I really hope that you guys are enjoying this video so far. So yeah, set little goals for yourself and try to achieve them, and then you can use that to measure your success rate or your success level. We're about to end this video, but then I'll go on to say that the reason I, for one, and I'm sure a lot of people now realize that external measurements or the societal measurement for success, the standard for measuring success in a society, any society, the reason I feel is flawed is because someone else is doing it. And I personally don't think you can tell me what to do to be successful. External measurements for success, they are flawed because they are made by someone else. I know what I like, I know what I don't like, I know how best I can work, I know my strengths, I know my weaknesses. That's why even if you go for an interviewer will not tell you, oh, so this is the strength that we're looking for. They want to hear what your strength is, and then they will now go back to deliberate and see, oh, can this strength, you know, come in handy, you know, as a member of our team, because of course other people too are going to have their strengths and weaknesses that can now combine into one. But imagine if they are giving every single one of applicants that are to be hired for a job, imagine if it is the interviewer that is telling you, oh, this is the strength we want to see in you. Of course they will ask for skills. Skills are definitely different. Your strength is like your area of focus, where you know that you are going to do that thing regardless of what circumstances might be, or regardless of the hurdles that you have to jump or face. Okay, so an interviewer will not tell like 5 people to be hired for different roles in a job that this is what we want your strengths to be, because then if it is that way, everybody will most likely end up doing the same thing, and there's no diversity. Diversity makes for good teams. I'm going to go ahead to give you tips on how you can evaluate your success. So I'm not going to tell you exactly what should be success to you, but I'm going to tell you the steps that you can take. So these steps can work for different people in different fields, or, you know, just different people. So yeah, the first thing I'm going to tell you, the first tip I'm going to give you on how to evaluate or measure your success the right way is, if you are entirely sure that you love your life in general, like the life you're living now, do you love it? Or you've already deviated from your personal, you know, definition of a life filled with self-love, living a life so that other people can be looking and, you know, be following, you know. Your life is not a reality show. Your life is for you to live, and you alone, not any other person. So yeah, the very first thing is, do you love your life? Whatever you're doing right now, do you? If not, you have to change direction. So when you are trying to put like measurements for success, rulers for success in place, be asking yourself these questions. Are you currently proud of yourself? There are times when I do stuff and I'm like, Dara, I'm so proud of you. Are you proud of? If you're not proud of yourself, it's time to start to be proud of you. Don't wait for someone else to tell you they're proud of you, because if you keep doing that, you might take forever or a lifetime Be proud of yourself. Do things that will make you feel proud of yourself, of the things that you've achieved. Another way I think you should actually measure success, because we need people that can, you know, change lives. The same way I feel like this video is going to help one or two people at the least to discover or, you know, redirect their lives to ensure that success to them is what they want it to be. See, one way or another, whatever you are doing, as much as I've said all of these things are for yourself, the whole purpose, I think, at the end of the day, of discovering yourself, you know, working on yourself, being able to determine what success means to you and all of that, is so that after you've seen yourself for you, after you've constructed your reality, you can then move on to help another person. So yeah, ask yourself if whatever you're going to be doing in the long run is going to help others. Even if it's one person, it helps significantly. You're on the right path. So the next one is that you have people who care about you. If you have people who genuinely care about you, they know that you are a success or know that you're successful because they see you for who you are and they are there for you, the lows, the highs. There are some of these things in my former video, like I said, please check that video or you go back. I must have linked it somewhere else. If you have people that genuinely care about you, surrounding you, they see who you are and they approve of it. And, you know, not even approve, they see who you are and they are there at every single moment to help you be a better version. And in actual fact, you don't need to advertise yourself to the world. These people already see when you do something that makes you proud of yourself. Another way, and I think this is the most important of all these ones, the last tip that I'm going to mention for you to be able to, you know, put in place measurements for your success is that you see progress. See, progress is important. It's very important. I see tweets on, you know, Twitter where people talk about how they started here and they got here. Trust me, it's not them boasting. They know how it feels. I know how it feels to have left a particular stage and move on to another stage. See, if you're progressing in this life, you are successful. You have every single bit of reason to be able to tell someone that I am successful because your status quo is changing from how it was before. Finally, to sum this video up, I would like to say that when you're happy, see, a lot of people are not happy. When you are happy doing what you want to do, being who you are, of course, there will be high and lows. There will be different days when you don't feel up to it at all, where you don't want to get up and do anything. But trust me, guys, defining what success means to you is all you need to now sit down, you know, create those goals. Like I said earlier in this video, create those goals, create those targets, and then work gradually towards achieving them. And for every single time that you move from point zero to point 0.1, trust me, you would feel proud of yourself. And then that, you know, that pride you feel in yourself will result into happiness. And if you're happy, then you're succeeding. All right, guys, that will be all for this video. Please let me know your thoughts in the comment section as usual. I really hope that you answered that question that I asked earlier on. Okay, what success means to you? I would really like to hear from you. If you've not answered that question up until now, please ensure that you answer that question. Just see it as some sort of feedback that I would like to also take into considerations for, you know, making decisions on other things or maybe further videos, a sequel perhaps again. And other people as well would definitely learn from you. And that is also important. Remember what we said in this video, you impacting people's lives is indeed one of the greatest measurements of success. Thank you guys so much for watching. Please hit on that red subscribe button if you've watched up until now. Thank you so much for staying to the end of this video. I really appreciate you. Guys, please subscribe to this channel. Subscribe to my channel. It will mean the absolute world to me. Also, share this video. Copy the link and share this video. See, you copying this, the link to this video is going to do a lot more for me than you can even realize, okay? Thank you so much, guys, for always supporting me. Thank you for supporting your girl. Your girl is not going to forget it when she blows, all right? Thank you so much, guys. And, you know, I'll see you in my next video by the special grace of God. Bye.